Hi, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we will continue exploring the ARM Cortex M architecture. I will show you step by step the instruction sets and the ARM core register that's located in the ARM CPU. Let's move forward. First is instruction sets. With the ARM architecture, it supports three main things of instruction sets. First is ARM instruction set, thumb instruction, and thumb true instruction set. Each has a different characteristics and designs for performance and the code density requirement. We will explore one by one. With the ARM instruction set, it has the size of instruction is 32 bit. It's designed for high performance computing, and typically used in scenarios where the performance is critical and high performance computing is required. With the instructions, it supports a wide range of complex instructions, which can handle multiple operations in a single instruction. That means with the ARM instruction set, the length of each instruction is 32 bits, and it is dedicated for the application that requires the performance processing is important. Right. So next, let's go to the thumb instruction set. With the thumb instruction set, it has the size of an instruction is 16 bit, and is designed for reducing the code size, optimized for higher code density, and suitable for embedded systems where memory is limited. With the performance, it has a lower performance compared to the ARM instruction set due to the reduced instructions. And it needs multiple instructions to perform the same task. With the thumb instructions, that means the size of each instruction is only 16 bits. So that's why the code size is reduced. About the performance, it has a lower performance compared to the ARM instruction set, and it takes multiple instructions to perform the same task compared to the ARM instructions. Finally, let's explore thumb true instruction set. With this thumb true, the size of an instruction combined between 16 bits and 32 bits. That means you can understand that combined between ARM instruction sets and thumb instruction sets, right? And it's designed to balance between code density and the performance. It takes the advantages of code density in thumb instruction sets and the performance benefits of ARM instructions. And is suitable for memory efficiency and requires high performance applications. In thumb true instruction sets, it takes the advantages of thumb instructions and the performance benefits of the ARM instruction set. Last summary, we have three instruction sets. First is ARM instructions, thumb instruction, and thumb true instruction. With the ARM instruction, it has 32 bits in each instruction. With thumb, it has 16 bits, and thumb true is combined between 32 bits and 16 bits in each instruction. With ARM instruction, is dedicated for high performance applications. Thumb instruction, because it has only 16 bits, so the code size is reduced. That's why it's false high cost density, right? And with time through instruction, it's balanced between the cost densities and high performance. That's why the time through instructions is a good choice to balance between the cost side efficiency and the high performance. With the time instruction, it is sufficient for the application that the memory is limited. And the ARM instruction, that is the performance is critical. Okay? Now let's explore the instruction sets in RealSense i41. First, let me wish and go to the C++ project setting. And go to the target process. So here is instruction set. First, let's try with ARM instruction set. Let's view it. Oh, this target CPU does not support AMOS. That is, RealSense i41 not supports AMOS or ARM instruction set, right? Now let's try with the thumb instruction set. I will select the thumb and thumb instruction set. Now let's delete it again. Okay, results no errors, no warnings. So i41 only supports the thumb mode or the thumb instruction set. The next, let's debug this with the i41 development kit. You can go to this assembly to view the instructions. Here you can see there are some instructions has designed in 2 byte or 16 bits. Here, 2 byte. And some other instruction has designed in 4 byte. Right, 4 byte equal to 32 bits, right, 2 byte, and 4 byte, right? So this combined between the ARM instruction set and the thumb instruction set, so that is thumb through instruction set. So RealSense i41 only supports thumb through instruction set, 2 byte and 4 byte, right? Let's go into the next section. The next section is ARM core register. In the ARM CPU, the core registers are located within the CPU itself, used for the executing instructions, storing temporary data, and controlling the operations of CPU. This one is ARM core register. That includes the first is general purpose register. General purpose register ran from the register 0 to register 12. The next is stack pointer. Stack pointer is register 13. Link register. Link register is register 14 and error. This one is link register. The next is program counter and PC register. And last is program status register that contains the program status of CPU and control bits and etc. We will explore it later. The first is general purpose register. General purpose registers used for data computation purpose. This one is general purpose register. With slow register from the register 0 to register 7. Is called low register. That could be accessible by spoon instruction. That means register 0 to register 7 could be accessible by 16 bits instruction and 32 bits instruction. And the next is high register. It's read from register 8 to register 12. That's not accessible by 16 bits instruction. With the instruction, you only access by 32 bit instructions. So with the thumb instruction set, you cannot access to this one, right? Because with the thumb instruction has only 16 bits on each instruction. Which general purpose register is used for computation data, such as adding, copying, saving, and calculating, etc. This one is an example for summation. We have the result variable equal to 5 plus 2. It will be converted into assembly codes like that. The first, the CPU move the value 5 into register 0, 5 into register 0. And the next is move through into register 1, and then the CPU plus register 0 and register 1 and store the result in register 2. The next, it will be load the address of result variable into register 3. And the last, it will be store result into result variable, right? That is the way the CPU performs processing data using general purpose register to do that. That's why we call it this general purpose register. So next is stack pointer register. Stack pointer register is one of the most important register in the microcontroller. Stack pointer points to the top address of the stack memory. Let me give you an example. For example, here is stack memory, and here is stack pointer register. Here's stack pointer register. This one is the current top address of this stack. For example, A is equal to 0, 0, 0. And now the stack pointer has to point to here, and address is 0, 0. When you push a new data to the stack, yes, a new data to here, and this address is 0, 0, 4. In this case, the stack pointer has to point to here, right? So the current values of stack pointer will be updated. And it will be 0x04, right? There are two types of stack pointer. First type is MSP, main stack pointer, and PSP, process stack pointer. Which PSP is used when running in thread mode? For example, with a multitask or in operating system like real-time OS. With a stack pointer in microcontroller, we usually process in MSP, means stack pointer, right? The next register is link register. Link register holds this return address when a subroutine call is complete. That's used for branching. Let's see in this example. The program is executing the function 1. The first is it calls the function 2. Before jump to function 2, the first it has to save the address of the next instruction of the function 2. This is the address of instruction 1. It is loaded into link register here. And then the PC register program counter register will be loaded by address of function 2, and then it jump to function 2. After executing function 2 is completed, The values of link register will be loaded into the PC register. Such is the address of instruction 1 will load to PC, and then the CPU will jump to instruction 1 and execute. We continue with the next register is PC register or program counter register. PC register holds the address of the next instruction to be executed. In the previous example, I have mentioned is in this example, here is PC to load the next address of the instruction to be executed. Here and here, right? And the last register is program stated register. SPSR. SPSR holds various status flags and control bits that represent the state of the processor. With PSR register divide two, three parts. The first, this figure, that is the PSR register layout. PSR register have three parts. The first is APSR, Application Program Status Register, that holds the various status flags. Here you can see the N and negative flag, zero flag, carry flag, etc. This flag to indicate that the status when performing calculation, etc. The next is IPSR, Interrupt Program Status Register, that holds the interrupt type number of the current ISA. When an interrupt and instruction is killed, is which holds the interrupt number or exception number here. And the last is EPSR or Execution Program Status Register, that indicates the processor is in the time state or not. You can see the T bits here when the CPU running on the time mode, the T bits here will be set to 1, and otherwise the T bits is 0, right? Okay, if my videos is helpful for you and give you the understanding about the embedded system or the microcontroller, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you and see you in the next video.